Hello once again, Star Wars and Unboxing fans. Welcome to another episode of Darth Tuba, Star Wars Unboxing Show. And I'm your host, Darth Tuba, and boy, do I have an unboxing show to get to, man. Look at all this, okay? I mean, just some crazy stuff. I kind of went a little nuts this week. And, you know, I appreciate everybody's support and everything else of that nature. I'd love to say that these are all mail-aways, you know, mail things that people sent me in the mail. I'm sadly not at that level yet. Maybe someday. But right now, no, I'm happy. I'm perfectly content just being my own little channel, and that's okay. So this is, if you watched the last episode, my Shelf Talk episode, you will know what this is. My previous unboxing show that happened a week ago had a... featured some 90s toys called BEND-EMS. And I got a few of them at a toy show, and I unboxed them, and I kind of looked at them and went, oh, these are cute. Then I looked at the back of the packaging, and I realized that, you know, there really wasn't a very large collection of BEND-EMS. There was a sizable, more than like two or three, I think there was about 20, but that was it. It was like two series, I think maybe, you know, six in the first one, 14 or something in the second one, and a case, and that was it. So I thought, well, that may be fun to try to track it down. Well, it didn't take very long, and it didn't take very much money. So I was able to do that, and you can see on some of our stickers here that eBay was the method of choice. And by the way, if you are a collector, eBay can be your absolute best friend, particularly if you're not into anything of like serious collectible value. And what I mean by that is, I mean, it's one thing if you're typing in something about Star Wars, and if you're typing in something about new action figures that you want to try to pick up that are supposed to be on the shelf, or if you're trying to find, you know, high-end collectibles. Yeah, eBay, these are just human beings without, you know, many of them, this is their, like, a secondary method of employment, self-employment, and they use this to make a little money. So if they buy a figure for, say, $125, they ain't selling it for $125. They're going to try to sell it for two or three times that. And sometimes they're successful and sometimes they're not. So, but in the case of the BEND-EMS, they, you know, this is a far less money. Most of these were, you know, a few bucks, $2, $3, $4. One or two of them were a little bit more, but collectively speaking, I don't think I spent more than like, you know, I spent under three figures. Okay. For this. And that was good. So we're going to get to that. But before we get to that, I do want to do a quick, shop report, as I started doing, and in this week I was able to track down in the stores, like in a Walmart, without any, you know, bribing of a manager, some new vintage collection figures. Okay, I knew that these were released very soon. We have the Mandalorian figures. This is a 3¾-inch, so these I think are the first Mandalorian figures to come out. And what do we have here? We have Cara Dune. Okay, and I'll get some close-ups. Probably put it on this one side or the other. But we have the Cara Dune figure. Now, I do not unbox these vintage ones unless I get a second one. I usually keep these in the package because I have a nice display in the other room, which I've shown. Look at my previous channel. And that's one. In addition to that, we also have the Remnant Stormtrooper. Now, this one I'm really hoping to pick up a few of these, but I do want to wait for the price to drop, maybe find them in Five Below or something, because they're the dirtied up Stormtroopers, a little different than what we've seen in the past. So, kind of, although probably similar to what you might have seen in maybe Rogue One or maybe Solo, okay, but these are a little higher end figures. So, Remnant Stormtrooper. By the way, the Cara Dune number is VC-164, and this is VC-165. And let's end it with VC-166. This is the way. That's right. The Mandalorian. He's finally in a 3¾-inch figure. Why couldn't he even come out before the holidays when I could have? I would have so bought a second one, and I would have put him on my gingerbread sandcrawler, and it would have been a whole Mandalorian thing, and I would have put a bunch of more Jawas, and it would have been so epic, and missed opportunity. So maybe I'll do... I have no idea what next year's... gingerbread project's gonna be, but who knows? We'll see. Maybe I can do the Razor's Crest, although it seems a little complicated for my level of gingerbread skill, but we'll see. So these are three of the vintage figures. As I said, do not open up the vintage collection figures unless I get a second one. So, and some people were like, hey, can we send you stuff? And I'm like, well, I don't want to give out my address. So maybe I'll do a PO box number, but Not sure. We'll see. All right. So let's enough talk. Let's get to these. We have a ton of things. And as I said, I've kind of let the cat out of the bag that these are all going to be related to the BEND-EMS collection. Okay. So I'm going to, what I think I want to do, I'm going to slide this over this way. All right. There we go. And I'll start with these two because I did have to make a few non-packaged versions because I couldn't find them any other way. And we're going to start with the most petite, or one of the most petite. And that is a little Ewok. Oh my God, look at him. Little Wicket. There he is. Wicket the Ewok. Played by Warwick Davis. And again, I'll get some close-ups over here next to the packages there. All right, there he goes. And oh, can you see him? Put him back here. He stands. He looks so cute standing like that. All right. Way to go. That is Wicket. Now, these were not very popular, and I understand why. We talked about that in the last episode. However, I do have a nostalgic take on them. I have an appreciation for anything. I have an appreciation for anything that was around when there was no Star Wars. Okay, so I have an appreciation for things like Heir to the Empire, Dark Force Rising, and The Last Command. Those are the three Timothy Zahn books that came out. Again, no Star Wars. Nothing. Nothing. Zilch. I have an appreciation for the Ewoks and the Droids cartoons. Okay, that was back when, and the Ewoks and the Ewoks movies, because that was when Star Wars was waning. Not much going on. So that's all we had. And I have an appreciation for the Disney Star Tours and all of what Disneyland did in 87 and what Hollywood Studios did in 89. That was it. Star Wars for a few years, that's the only place you could find any new product, anything, was at Disneyland and Disney World. So that's why I always have an affinity for those things. But now, let's go from the smallest little Wicket figure to the most epic and the most expensive, mind you. I won't say how much, but let's just say out of all of this, this was the most expensive, and it was loose, and that is Boba Fett. Boba Fett is just cool, I guess, in any form, even posable, bendy kind of form, okay? But he's cool. He comes with a weapon. You know, he works out good. Now, let's see. Does he pass the stand test? Of course he does. He's Boba Fett. Of course he passes the stand test, for goodness sake. So I'm gonna put these two over here on the side because I got a lot more to get through. All right, so let's keep moving here. Now, folks, I have not screened. Oh, I only screened one box because I got two large boxes here, and I was like, why do I have two large boxes? I only ordered one thing that was considered larger, but then I realized it was something that was kind of medium, and they put it in a big box. So that's kind of why. So. All right, and this is a package that has another box. And inside the other box is somebody that you should not judge by size. Judge not by size. Because, and also, stop being sticky. Thank you. I want to thank all the eBayers that. All right, there we go. We have the Jedi Master Yoda. Okay, and we're going right into full out unboxing. Okay, because this is something I want to put them in their displays with the case, with the display case, and we'll leave it at that. Yoda, they all look like this. Okay, Yoda, again, you know, obviously when you look at something that's out of the package, it's lost some of its luster, lost some of its shine. But Yoda, pretty cool. So we'll put Yoda and Yoda will survive the stand test. There you go, see? And he comes with his own Star Wars Galaxy's trading card, so that's cool. I'm going to leave the pile here in the front. You can really see it, so that's good. All right, moving right along here. Let's kind of continue our efforts. Thank you to those of you sending stuff in semi or full recyclable materials, okay? Better for the environment. I'm very curious to see how Hasbro handles, they wanna have no plastic in their packaging. I'm really hoping that they follow through in that. I'm definitely one to, I mean, I do a collect plastic for a hobby, like toys, but at least they're going to stay out of the landfill for most of my life, for my whole life, and then eventually I'm hoping someone else's life. So I think you have a better shot of keeping them away from that. All right, moving on. This is BEND-EMS. This is a different series. This is a 94 series, a second series, and this is Luke Skywalker, but in X-Wing pilot gear. And again, these were not the most high-end figures, so as a result, the packaging is coming loose for many of them. So I'm going to try to bring his arms down. Pretty cool. No helmet, sorry to say, but, you know, and he's kind of have that similar funky gaze. I'm not sure what's going on here with the boots. It's got this like piano key thing or just this black and white stripe. I don't recall that being on the boots. I could be wrong, but maybe that was just an artistic rendering. So, like, does he survive the stand test? All right, bend him forward a little bit. Bend him forward a little bit. Continue to bend him forward. Maybe not. 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2. He doesn't survive the stand test. It's okay. As I said, I'm going to put them in the case when we're done. So the case will be the last thing we open up. It does come up with a cool Galaxy, Star Wars Galaxy. You know what I think I might do is I might put the figure and the card together and on display so you can see them. A nice, cool rendering of Luke. All right. Okay, that's all of our packaged stuff. So now I got to work on the these boxes. And boy, people, there's some interesting box types here. Now, there's a chance that I have a few doubles. Okay, so maybe on the few doubles, I'll consider a giveaway. We'll see. All right, we've got C-3PO, human-cyborg relations. All right. So funny, though, like, you know, this is like, the packaging is so flimsy, you know, and comparatively. It's crazy. So there he is. Now, will C-3PO, survive the stand test? Here we go. Come on, C-3PO. You're a droid. You're programmed for etiquette and protocol and standing. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. With a little prompting, I think it would work, but... All right. Excuse me, there's some dust coming off of these boxes here. Woo! All right, let's move on. We're getting down here, guys. It's good. And again, the BEND-EMS figures are not the most high-end figures. And some people are like, why are you collecting those? That's kind of silly. Well, for one thing, you know, I have limited funds, folks. So collecting... I collect what I can, you know, and I can collect a set of BEND-EMS figures, and I liked them. I thought they were fun. I didn't think they were, you know, stupid. I just think that before we had, you know, if they were believe me, let me tell you this much. If they were all we had, you can guarantee these things would have been the hottest thing out there, okay? You can guarantee. I bet you anything. Hey, what have we here? We have Lando, General Lando Calrissian. Another one that was a little pricier. I don't know why. Maybe it's his cool uniform. Maybe it's just because he's Lando. Hello. And he has this neat art card there. Okay. And he's got his really cool general outfit. Of course, no cape. Yeah, BEND-EMS, you should have given him a cape. Lando is never seen without a cape. Well, I shouldn't say never, but hardly ever. So, but I guess when he's piloting the Falcon, he doesn't have one. I guess when he's escaping Bespin, he doesn't have one. So that's probably not it. But it's just, you always should have a cape. All right. So let's see, does Lando, come on. Lando is too cool not to survive the stand test. Yay, Lando, because he's cool. And what does he say? Works every time. If your kids don't know what that is, it's good, you know. All right, so Lando, you can kind of pop yourself over there. All right, moving on here, we've got, how many minutes ago? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 plus we had 5 in the last episode, so that's 11. right, so we'll see what we have left. Ooh, this one's nice. Little plastic bag. Okay. Ooh, this one's got fancy eBay paper. Cute. All right. We have the Gamorrean Guard, Pig Guard. Man, these things, like, these babies look like, it's so funny, like, the first set look a lot more shabby than the second set. I think they were pretty popular collectibles when they first came out. And then, then what happened in 95? This is 93 and 94. What happened in 95? Star Wars was back, baby. It was back with, like, regular action figures. So then these guys were like, oh, what about us? And they all got relegated to discount racks and dollar stores. But anyway, here's the Gamorrean Guard, looking really cool. He might stand. He's not that smart, but I'm thinking with a little bit of coaxing and a little bit of bending. Can you see him? He's being blocked by there. Ah! Dang it! You were just there. Gamorrean survives the test. All right, cool. I think he's going to fall any second, but he does survive the test because it counts. It counts. I'm going to stand you right over here. All right, now, we do have a couple of boxes here. I should have probably thought this through ahead of time, but I'm going to do this one first. I've already kind of pre-screened this one just because I did not know why I was receiving two big boxes, and then I realized as soon as I half-opened this one why that was the case, and that was because this box had a mega set. Oh my god, look at this. A mega set. Oh my god, I didn't even never knew a this collectible figure set. I never even knew it happened. And wow, this thing is saran wrapped up good and tight. Okay. I say I never knew, but I should say I don't recall, because all things being equal, there was a lot of stuff coming out, and this makes sense if they were worried about trying to get rid of these. And I think, come on, here we go. I'm making a big mess here in the Darth Tuba studio when you have, like, 15 boxes. All right, look at this baby, man. There's your eight, what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 pack. 10 pack. 10 pack of figures. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Now, there are a few in here that I already have, I think. So we're going to have to kind of, oh, yeah, poor Han Solo. Sorry if that buzzed a little bit. Wow, this is crazy, man. And what's really cool about this is that it comes, hang on. They're very packaged stuff very interestingly. Ugh. I'm trying to get the cards out of here, but they're being difficult. Ooh, this comes with comes with an actual gold, like metallic, not just plastic, but an actual coin, a Star Wars coin. Has Millennium Falcon on the back. Looks like it's got some damage on it because of the plastic coating. But the Star Wars logo is good. I'll get a close-up of that. And along with that, you've got a whole bunch of cards here. Ooh, except the sticker. Now this one, you would have thought that this would come with cards that had to do with everybody, but it doesn't. We have a Chewie, we have a Obi-Wan and a Chewie sticker, a Chewie card. And the same as with the Obi-Wan and Chewie. And then it's just an X-Wing TIE Fighter, some old poster art. So they're okay, but not in the same level of cool. All right. But now we're not here for those. Let's just go through them. All right. Here we go. Ready? Emperor's Royal Guard. Does it pass? First of all, they're like the other, cloaked figures. There's no legs. Passes the test. Boom! Bib Fortuna. Does he pass the test? Again, no bottom. Boom. Passes the test.
Admiral Akbar, it's a trap.
I know, I do that. My favorite character. My favorite ancillary character of the Star Wars saga of films. He better pass the test. Yeah, you can be sure that Admiral Akbar passes the test. Although I am going to like lean him here against the 3PO. All right, moving on. Oh, we already have a Vader with his fancy little cape. Now, my other Vader had a hard time with this. So we'll see here. Does this Vader do any better? Why do you not? Yep. He passes the test. Barely, but he passes. Okay, I'm going to tuck him back here. All right, keep moving on. Luke Skywalker, but farm boy Luke. It comes with a lightsaber. Really cool. All right. And use the Force, Luke. And he did, and he does. Brilliant. I'm actually going to pop him up here on top of the Death Star. All right, what else we got? Come on, just a few more. All right. Almost there. Let me get them all out of here because this is like... I mean, the box was great, but it was very flimsy. It was very, very flimsy, and it looked like... No, Luke! If that's... You don't fall there. That's an Empire. All right. Chewbacca. All right, Chewbacca. Does he pass the test? I'm going to say... Never underestimate a Wookiee. Yes, he passes the test. Now this Han Solo, let's see if he passes. He's very pristine and proper. He's got like very sticky. Now that's the one thing I will say this about this kind of stuff, guys. BEND-EMS are made of a latex kind of rubber. Guess what? Latex rubber, sorry to say, doesn't last. These were not meant to be put away and taken out 100 years from now. So if you put these away in their packaging and take them out, Han passes the test. You take them out 20 years from now, you might notice that if they start to break down. Actually, all plastics break down to some degree, but these are going to break down a lot faster. Okay, the bendable quality, it's just going to happen. So be aware of that. Excuse me. Can't get my words out today. Leia has very, very tiny shoes, which makes her trying to pass the test difficult. All right. I'm pretty sure that R2 does. Good. And lastly, but not leastly, we got our Stormtrooper. All right. And he passes. All right. Very good. But now, because of what's coming next, I'm going to ask all you guys to just kind of move over. And we got the final boxing, or unboxing, rather. If anybody is interested in sending anything that they want to see unboxed on the channel, shoot me a comment and I'll see what I can do. Maybe I'll come up with something. Oh, I'm so excited. Oh, I hope this is what I think this is what I want. Yes, it is. Oh my goodness. Gracious me. It is a Darth Vader collector's case, but not any collector's case. This is not one for regular action figures. It's one for BEND-EMS. That's right. It's pretty much the same setup, but it's one for the BEND-EM figures. It's a little bit different. Okay, it's got a similar kind of setup to it, but I am going to end this video by putting all the figures in, and I'll kind of do a visual show. Now, let me see here for a minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. All right. So we'll see how we can do this. I don't have all the figures here, so I'll just do the ones I have. All right. We've got normal size figures that can fit here. One. We'll put Vader. We're going to put the Royal Guard up here. Kind of interesting. You do have to, maybe not. This is going to be interesting because I don't think every single figure is going to fit. I think that you have to kind of be careful where you put certain figures, and then you just kind of cover them up. I'm sure that originally there was a do this. Get Akbar in there. Come on, Akbar, can you fit in there? Maybe not. All right. Akbar maybe in here. Boy, this is kind of a challenge. It's like a puzzle. Can we get them all in there? Let's see. Vader, how about you? How about Vader in this way? All right, cool. And how about the Gamorrean? Ooh, you're a big fella. I don't know if you are going to have a good place to go here. I'm going to have to fit you in here sideways. Yeah, I'm going to probably just leave them in this case because I have a feeling that eventually these things are going to break down. And if they're going to break down, I'd rather them break down in the case. You know, no sense having a breakdown on a display. We'll put there, and this one here, and Chewie, you're gonna go. You're the other tall dude. You're gonna go here, and we got Admiral Akbar. I guess he can go here. Oh, Bib Fortuna. Oh no, what do we do about Bib? Poor Bib Fortuna. That's a tough one. And then R2, the little one. 3PO. Oh my god, we're running out of... Oh, you know, I think 3PO can fit in here. Lando, we can fit here. Next to he'll be on the other side of Leia. That'll be fun. Luke. Both Lukes. We got Luke here. And we got Luke here. All right, so there they go. They're all in there, okay? And I guess along with that, since I have a little bit of open box here, I'll use this to stack all the cards and the coin. And then the true test is, can this thing close? Come on there, buddy. There we go. And you're here, and you're here. I still have the five figures from the previous collection to get in here, but there it is, my collector case. I will add those other figures. It is complete. My collection is now complete. They made a fine addition to my collection. But it's nice. And then I have a few of these Vader cases. And this one can be in there, you know, kind of be on display. And I can open it up. You can display it like this. You can display it like this. It's pretty cool. So, success. I have completed a collection. That never happens. I have completed a collection. There's no other collection I've completed. So I'm really excited about this. Even though it wasn't that expensive. And it's not worth that much. And it's probably all going to decay and melt away and be nothing in about 100 years. But who cares, right? I won't be here for that. So that'll do it for this week's episode of Darth Tuba Star Wars Unboxing Show. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, hit the notification button. Do all that stuff. Smash the like button. Let's get some likes going here. All right? And tell other subscribers about it, okay? Tell other subscribers. Now, I haven't forgotten about those that were, you know, about the last episode where we were talking about the which battle packs to do. But if you don't know what I'm talking about, go check out the last episode I dropped. It was a Shelf Talk episode where I'm actually letting you, the viewer, determine what's the next couple of battle packs and figure packs I'm going to unbox. I have about 8-9 choices. You can just leave a comment as to which choice you want. I'll take the one that is selected the most, and if we have a tie, I'll, you know, pin them up against each other for like another kind of like a March Madness thing. We'll see. All right, so thank you so much for watching. We'll get the results of that soon. Until next time, may the Force be with you.